First, I would like to thank all our friends and participants on this virtual seminar, and it is also the in the whole the world, it is a challenge for us. The global capitalism is invading our every matters of the life, from kitchen to the anything else, to the forest and river and sea. Today, we have been experiencing that even a crisis, that a global crisis we are facing as a climate change, and as well as also, though it temporarily, but it is the coronavirus, that is the COVID-19. But the national governments throughout the world, they do not realize to do the environmental justice or economic justice or any justice to as a human being. Everything is violated by the elected government as well as also the naturally the dictatorial regimes in the world. And this is a challenge for us, because the name of recovery, of economy, the countries like India, though it's a vast democratic country, we have parliament, we have legislative assembly, we have judiciary, independent judiciary. But today, the corporate captured every institutions, the parliament, the judiciary, the bureaucracy, and the policy making systems of our country. And it happens everywhere in the world. The capitalist country like USA or anywhere. So this is a challenge for us. How to challenge? How to make, this is the way only Mahatma Gandhi, our father of nation, and as the world leader for peace and nonviolence, he had taught us that we can challenge the imperialism or neoliberal economy through the nonviolent people's struggles, mass movement. And this is a challenge before us everywhere. I think we are now, I can say, in India, where I am working in Odisha also, we have got this result through mass movement, non-violent movement, that Niyamgiri has been saved from unscrupulous mining of bauxite by Vedanta Company. The people struggle, as well as the legal struggle in the Supreme Court, that gave the verdict that peoples are the owners of the natural resources. And it is a fact that even in our constitution, the indigenous people's community are the owner of resources. But the state is a corporate state, police state. The state is doing injustice through unconstitutional rules, regulations, policies to destroy the natural resources, whether it is forests, rivers, or coasts, in name of development. And this capitalistic development destroys the lives of the millions of people who depends upon the natural resources as gift of nature. And in Niyamgiri, this non-violent mass struggle by the indigenous people like Dongriya communities, we could achieve. And because of this movement, and as well as also our constitutional provisions, the Supreme Court had to accept the supreme right of the common people over the natural resources. And today, in India, it is a glorious day for our movement. Though It is a challenge for us. The democracy is going to be perilled. Democracy is going to be threatened. Democracy is going to be reduced to a just dictatorship. Though there is an elected government in India, but the farmers, the laborers, the landless people, they have come together throughout the country under the banner of Sanjukta Kisan Morcha, the United Farmers Forum in India, who have challenged the Indian government's dictatorial regime and three black class, which will destroy our agriculture economy as well as also the food security. So today is 113th day. 300 farmers have died, sacrificed life. And that is the through the non-violent, peaceful, democratic mass movement, which challenged the not only 13th government of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi and its party, but also to the corporate captures, to corporate regime. Because today, the media, the bureaucracy, the politics, and the ruling parties are controlled by the corporate money. And that is the first time in India after independence, this mass movement has challenged the globalization, neoliberalism, as well as also the corporate capture. I think this will continue. Today also, I'm in a journey of campaign to challenge this loss in a state like Odisha. We've started from 12th and will end on 23rd. That is the martyr day of Bhagat Singh, Shahid Bhagat Singh. And this is our challenge for us, how to make movement more strange, more to increase and momentum of this movement, to spread the momentum of this movement, to create awareness among the people, the farmers, to challenge the corporate captures, the corporate authorities, the corporate regime, as well as also to protect our natural resources like agriculture, land, forest, and rivers. So this is an era of now challenge. I think I appeal to all of our friends in the world, those who are challenging the globalization, let us unite globally, fight globally, and act locally to challenge the corporate regime, corporate captures, to protect our democracy and democratic rights. Thank you all.